Brand new coffee tech break with Jan. And as we're slowly moving into the Christmas period, I thought, let me change a little bit of the scenery here to get a little bit in the mood. So hopefully you enjoyed my last videos where I showed you the Studio USB. I showed you how to manage Studio USB, which you can now do from Lens, which I really recommend to start testing, because Lens, as I said earlier, is really a platform for work where you're able to manage all of the devices from Poly. Now, I also showed you a tech tip, for example, how to pair a Bluetooth remote back to Studio USB when you, for example, have factory reset it or something. It's always a way to pair it again. But if you got any other things that you run into, just let me know in the comments, and I will try to create a coffee tech tip to give you some insights in those options. Now, today, I think I got another great video, and that is about the software available now, GA, the 323 for Studio X and G7500. It's now publicly available on support.polycom.com, so you can download it for an offline upgrade. Just download the package and put it on a stick, on the root of a stick. You plug it in to the X3050, and you can upgrade. It's very easy. Now, if you hooked up to the internet, you can schedule it through the web UI or force an upgrade manually. Always recommend just read through the release notes, etc., where you can find all the additional information. But I really wanted to share some highlights with you. I will walk that through in a small presentation, because I usually like to do a hands-on, but this time I have a small presentation to run the features through. Now, I would say grab a cup of coffee and I will run through all the highlights that I have. Now, 3.2.3, it's available now on the public website. So I recommend to upgrade to this latest version, as there's a lot of new functionality in there. But before I run through all that new functionality, I wanted to take a step back. Yes, usually I take a step forward, but today I will take a step back. Because how is the whole Studio X and G7500, how is the whole architecture? I think that is good to know. So what are the base features on the hardware layer and the software layer and on the application layer? And so I wanted to walk that through in a sort of presentation. Now, in the basic layer, so that is the lower layer, the hardware layer, what you see there is all kinds of capabilities. So we see there the HDMI ingest, for example, to share content. We got 4K cameras in there. We have AirPlay and Miracast, so you can walk in with your iPhone or with your iPad and share content. We got H323 SIP. So you could dial via RealConnect into Teams, or using the ZRC to dial into a Zoom environment. So you've got all those capabilities in there. You got dual monitor, touchscreen support. So even with G7500 and with the X50, you got dual touchscreen support. I think very, very powerful. What is also available is the USB mode. So USB mode, or we call it device mode. If you look at the specific setting at device mode, what you can do is you can reuse the camera, speaker, and mic in the device and use that on your laptop. And that's all available. We got camera tracking, so speaker track or group track. It's fully packed with features. Now, these are all available in it. Poly OS story. Yeah? So that means if you run the Poly application, you have all those benefits to use that. Now, if you look at running those other applications, for example, the Teams app or the Zoom app or the Log Me In app, so there's all kinds of apps there, then it will depend on the specific vendor what it will be provided. So that is, I think, very important. For example, dual screen is today available in the Teams app and in the Zoom app. The rest is all single screen today. And so please be aware of that. And as I said, that is when I created this video. But it could be that the other providers will at the end also support dual screen. But it's always good to check those capabilities. HDMI ingest is today only available in the Zoom app, but will, for example, be available in the Teams app moving into next year. So, as I said, all those capabilities could come through at the end, but well, that will depend on those specific video providers. That's, I think, very good to know. Now, with this in mind, let me take you now through the new version 3.2.3. So first of all, we got updated apps. And specifically for this version, we got an updated Teams app and an updated Zoom app. So this is important. And probably in every release that we come out with, we will incorporate the latest from those providers. Now, what is also important is some of them provide updates through their own administration portal. For example, if you look at Zoom and you got the Zoom admin portal, there you can provide also software updates if you want. Teams Admin Center, same thing. That is also a possibility to provide updates. I don't know about other providers, but in case there isn't an update procedure from those providers, you can always enable the automatic update policy. So that means it will check as soon as there's an update. You can schedule this to do this at night. You can schedule an update. And this will not only update the X3050 G7500, but it will also update the TC8 hooked up to it. Very important. So we always have an update policy as a backup for those devices. Now, what is new in the MTR for Android? And as you can see, I'm already using the new naming. In the past, we called it the Teams collaboration bar. But as we move forward, everything will be renamed to MTRA, MTR for Android, or MTRW is MTR for Windows. So that is good to know. So I will call it MTR for Android. And specifically, we got update 3 now. And as I said, this is available now through Teams Admin Center, or you can upgrade your board to the 3.2.3, and you will have this new version available. What is in this new version? Good to know. We got 1080p receive, very important. So the resolution has changed now to 1080p receive. In the next version, coming in the new year, we will also do stand. So that is good to know. This is the first piece of it doing the receive. Next thing is spotlight support. So here you can spotlight if you are in a training, if you are in an educational session, you can spotlight it now on the MTR for Android and get the person in big screen. So that is the possibility now. Request to speak, and especially also in the educational market, if you need to request and want to speak, you can get in line now by request to speak, which is available now on the MTR for Android. Next one, which was a big request, is the 9 participants. So you can show now 9 participants on the screen, 3x3 layout, which was already in the client and is now also available in MTR for Android. So I think a great improvement to get a much bigger overview of the participants inside the rooms. Also a big request is a dual screen support. So we have for the X50, we have dual screen support now. So you can put the participants on one screen, and you can put the content on the other screen. And you can probably put content on two screens if you want. There will probably be some layouts. But as I haven't tested it, I don't know that yet. But something you can probably try out. And next one is the new meeting layouts. So we have now this together mode. And so where you can sit sort of stadium together and put everybody in a seat. And we got large gallery support. Something which was already in the PC client, which is now also available on the MTR for Android. I think great improvements there. Also, some other things like auto answer might be interesting for an executive room when somebody wants to set up that remotely as a white glove service or something, so you can set auto answer, or you can set the call quality. The next version, I don't know if you can see it here, we will get the TC8 updated to the same view as we have on the MTR for Windows. And this will be a great improvement. So this will be an update coming into the next year. So I'm really looking forward to it. So if you walk into a personal, small, mid-sized, or bigger rooms with the G-Series, the MTR for Windows, all those rooms have the same layout and control. Now, what I wanted to highlight is there was a video session with New Fluster and Raul, one of the product managers at Microsoft, specifically responsible for Android. That is available on New Fluster's YouTube channel. And so they had a session about that last week. They even showed live dual screen X50 TC8 with the new control and the new layout on the touch panel. So if you want to get a sneak peek, I really recommend to go to New Fluster's YouTube channel where you can review that video with Raul. It's really nice to see that progress. Also, what became available is certification. Certification in the form of all the vendors need to test it in all kinds of different settings, laptops, clients, versions, etc. And they need to comply with a certain audio quality, etc. So we have now the Sync 20 officially certified now with Teams, and it's officially certified for Zoom. So it complies with that quality, which is required by those vendors. So it's a catch-up. Always, it becomes available. It should work out of the box, but it always takes some time, as I said, to go through all the testing and get that certification. So we have that available now for the Sync 20. And the rest of the portfolio, Sync 40 and Sync 60, also will be released coming in the new year. So I'm really, really looking forward to that. Another exciting release is now the availability of multiple camera support with the Zoom app. So you can now hook up to an X50 or G7500 running the Zoom app. You can switch cameras. So that's just available on the TC8, or if you got a touchscreen, you can also rotate cameras. And that means specifically for educational world or any other application, you can now switch those different sources. I think in today's world, this is a really, really powerful one. Also in the medical world, I can imagine you want to switch cameras or switch sources, etc. So you can do that now. G7500 has an HDMI in, has three USB ports. X50 has also two USB ports and a HDMI in, and so it's available for those devices to switch between cameras. And also if you use the automatic speaker track cameras, like Studio USB or the Eagle Eye Cube, you can also hook up those devices and use that automatic camera tracking. I think really powerful. I just recommend to start testing, experimenting with it. Now, another great enhancement is the USB device mode. So this gets updated every new version. And now they added the volume slider. So USB device mode means you can reuse camera, speaker, and mic through the USB cable in your laptop. So you run the video app on your laptop, the WebEx, Google Meet. It doesn't matter. You can use any video client and the camera, speaker, and mic will be on top of the screen. Now, that can be also in one of the apps. So for example, if you're running the Zoom app, you could put it in the USB device mode. And then if people walk in for a quick WebEx call, they can just connect that USB cable to the laptop and use the system. Now, if then a user walks out, and then after 30 or 40 seconds, the system will be back into the Zoom mode. So I think it's a really great feature. And more apps are supporting this this USB device mode. So I always recommend check the release notes, which apps support that today. Now, also an enhancement in here is that you can turn it off. So in case you don't want to support other functionality than supporting the app which you're using, you can turn it off. So there is now an option here under the collaboration tools where you can turn the setting fully off. And then your system will be fully in Zoom or in Teams or any app you're running, and people are not able to break out. Now, lastly, another great feature, I think, is the remote monitor support. So we have in this 3.2.3, you can now remotely monitor the far-end camera and the local camera. So in case you're doing some white glove service, you want to make sure that the camera is aligned with the room, or anything else you want to do to make sure that the call is correctly running, we have that available now. So you can even wake up the camera. So if you want to prepare something for a specific room, you're able to do that. So remotely, you can run some tests. If the lights are running, for example, in the room, or if the equipment is prepared, you can do that now doing the remote monitoring. I tried it to keep it within a coffee break. So I'm already looking forward to my next videos. I will probably give you an update on the brand new smart speakers from Poly. And this is the Sync 60. And I will run you through all the benefits and features that are available. And this will be coming into the brand new year. Thank you for watching this video. And I'm looking forward to see you all in the next video.